Your divine blueprint is stored within the white fire seed atom at the base of the spine within the second spiraling column of Kundalini light. Rana, would you elaborate on that, please?
Sure. It is a little confusing, but these are things that we have been given as we progress. As you know, the catechus, the symbol of the medical profession, it shows two entwined serpents joining like in a striking cobra at the top. And so in the Kundalini fire, there is two memory seed atoms, white fire memory seed atoms stored within the root chakra when we came into the physical body. And so one of those contains a storehouse. If you will remember when we first talked about adamantine particles, there is a storehouse of adamantine particles stored within one of those white fire seed atoms. And as we begin to balance and harmonize the chakra system, as you know, the chakra system has become distorted and out of balance. And that rod of power that goes up the spine is only just a very thin, let's just see it as a very thin cord that runs up and down and connects all the chakras and then out the crown chakra and that silver cord, that lifeline, okay? And so as we began to open those seven seals, the chakra system, and you see we do that once we reach that mid-fourth, or let's say that we have to be at a mid-fourth dimensional frequency level to tap into the adamantine particles of light. That is the prerequisite. Before that, we are drawing primal life force substance, which is a limited or a half spectrum of light, which can be used both positively or negatively. That is what humanity is using now. The primal life force substance, so that we are creating the good and the negative. But when we reach or balance and harmonize to the point where we are tapping into the heart chakra is the gateway to the higher dimensional frequencies, the gateway to the mid-fourth dimensional level of existence and the higher frequencies of light. That's when we begin to balance and harmonize. So when we begin to open and balance and harmonize the chakra system, then those adamantine particles begin to flow up. That first, you might say, spiral of the Kundalini is the one that activates the seven chakras, opens the rod of power, goes up through, like you talked about, the carotid artery, the pineal, the pituitary, out the crown, the lotus, opens the lotus, begins that process of widening that antacorona, widening that rainbow bridge, widening that pathway, that liver of life, so that now the adamantine particles can also begin to come down through the column of light. And we have opened our sacred heart, the back portal, so we're getting them from three different directions. That is when the extension process begins to accelerate. And so then after that rod of power, where we are now, that rod of power is light, it's activated, and we're connecting and we're moving up the fourth dimension. That second Kundalini fire seed atom now has activated in those of us who are ready to tap into our fifth dimensional sacred triad. And that memory seed atom contains our divine blueprint for this next age. And so that is beginning to rise up and to do its work within our chakra system, transmuting our body, digging deeper into our DNA, transforming our DNA and bringing forth those portions of the DNA that now are ready to be activated and others are being shut down. So it is creating so much magic within our cellular level and within our body as it begins to move upward. So we are being bombarded by the higher frequency rays from the higher dimensions. Those are coming into us as well as internally with this second rod of power that contains our divine blueprint. So is it any wonder that you feel that you hardly know who you are or where you're going or where you've been and that you're feeling like you really do not know who you are these days because we are transforming so quickly?